Hello, everybody. Welcome, and it's good to see you today. You know, we are emotional people, and we can just go out of control without us even knowing it, depending on life circumstances. Well, let me share with you what happened to me recently, where, you know, life is a surprise. Everything is peachy keen in my life, and I was just driving to work one morning, and I was at peace, and all was good. Then suddenly, I was about to make a right turn. I came from a stop, and I was about to make a right turn, and I went a little forward, but then I stopped because I saw an oncoming car, and I wanted to be safe. But sure enough, when I stopped, all of a sudden, a big jolt came about, and I got rear-ended. I thought to myself, oh wow, that's great. It wasn't a big jolt, but it was enough that I thought I should go over to the side and take a look. So I went out of my car, and the person who hit me from behind, he looked like he was so stressed already, handing me information. And I took a look at my car, and there were some minor scratch marks behind my car and in front of his car. And it was sad. It was his 32nd birthday, and I felt bad for him. I thought, oh, wow, what a way to start your day. And, you know, we took pictures of the car and exchanged each other's insurance information. And I called my work, my assistant, and my first clients of the day saying I'm going to be delayed because I got rear-ended. They were kind and gracious. They said, I hope you're okay and no worries. So, you know, just the goodness about being good to one another is very, very important, because sometimes certain things could just trigger us without us even knowing it. You know, I could have been triggered right away by being rear-ended on my way to work, and it could have set me off in a bad mood, being late, starting off the day, knowing that it's going to be a busy morning. Or I could have offset a bad mood for my first client. Maybe she would have been in a hurry to go somewhere, and she may have been agitated in her voice when I informed her. All kind of things could have happened. It could have taken a turn for the worst. But you know, I try to stay calm, cool, and collected, and I drove to work. And when I arrived to work, all was good. You know, my assistant was there waiting for me, my client. They seemed like they were peachy keen, and I was very gracious and thankful for them. And I just continued on. And then as the day went about, I felt like maybe I was perspiring, because all of a sudden on my pants, I felt that it was pretty wet, I thought. So I thought, maybe because I was standing outside in the heat, trying to exchange insurance with the person who rear-ended me, I thought maybe I was just, you know, in a deep perspiration. So I felt my whole pants was soaking wet. Then a little strange thought in my mind happened. I think I should go to perhaps the ladies' room and check things out just in case. And to my great surprise, the monthly woman's time came, and it was just an outpour of blood. I'm sorry to be that graphic. All over, thankfully, my black color pants, not white color pants. And you couldn't see through it. And I was just starting to get a little stressed. But, you know, when I was in the restroom, I just started laughing. I found humor in the situation. You know, first of all, I was peaceful in my mind driving to work. Then I got rear-ended, delayed at work, and then this outpour of blood on my pants that was black color, thank goodness. And I was just laughing. And that verse, Nehemiah, just, you know, do not be grieved, but the joy of the Lord is our strength. And I encourage you today in this video, please try to find some type of humor. Sometimes when there's so many stressful events that happen suddenly, these curveballs that happen abruptly, you know, we can lose our cool and we can just get triggered in a very ugly, negative way. We can lash out. It could just ruin our day. But when God wants us to, in our mind, just to, you know, just do not fear, just have a sound mind, just have a mind of love, and just be good to one another, that will keep us in peace. I like to share with you this verse from 2 Thessalonians 3 verse 3, it says, but the Lord is faithful and he will strengthen you and protect you from the evil one. I know the enemy, he just loves to use any means just to get us triggered and just to get us down and beat up and just try to get a stronghold in our life. You know, use any kind of weapon possible just to get the best of us and just to create a lot of turmoil and chaos in our mind, in our circumstances, and just make us agitated one way or another. But I love that verse I share many times, John 10:10. It says, the thief comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But I, Jesus, have come to give you life and to have it abundantly till it overflows. So as believers, remember who and whose you are. You are God's child. You are beloved God's child. We are so worthy and valued in his eyes. He has his name tattooed in the palm of his hands. He knows the number of our hair. How personalized can that be? And God cares for each and every one of us. He wants us to be in peace and not to get agitated and not to lose our self-control in any way. That all comes from the enemy and his tactics to defeat us and to bring us down and to just make us have a bad day. And that can make a ripple effect to other people around us if we're not doing well. But I'd like to share with you 1 Peter 5:7, and it says to cast all your anxiety on him because he cares for you. So truly, if you feel like you have a lot of worries, concerns, anxieties that can get the best of you, I just encourage you, take that deep breath, inhale and exhale, and release all the anxieties and worries and just cast it onto God, because he does promise to take care of each and every one of us today. God is faithful and he will strengthen us and he will help us with the joy of the Lord is our strength. Let's keep our eyes vertically up and let us always trust in God no matter what happens in our circumstances, because he will make it all for good for his glory. I'd like to leave you with 1 Peter 5:7. It says, Isaiah 26:30. I apologize. You will keep him in perfect peace, whose minds are steadfast because they trust in you. God bless you. You know, it is the most difficult thing, a challenging thing for all of us as humans to trust in God, our Heavenly Father. But let us hold on to his promises, his faithfulness. He wants the best for us. He's going to take care of us no matter what. He provides for us in surprising ways, in mysterious ways. It is over and beyond amazing how God works and reigns in our life. Let us trust in God's sovereignty today. And my scenario with getting rear-ended and being late for work and, just having the little accident, it could have turned for the worse. You know, I could have just been maybe in a fight or conflict with the man who rear-ended me, with the customers. They could have gave me stress, and I could have worn white pants. I mean, it would have been a catastrophe. But when we laugh and find humor, that is where we find our strength. And when we know who and whose we are in Christ, that joy of knowing God gives us the strength. And how much worse can it be, you know, in any scenario? But if it does turn for the worse in your scenario, just know that God's got your back. Just let us learn to cast all our cares and worries onto God. And he promises in and through his faithfulness that he will take care of you. And we will be able to bring all glory and praise and credit to our Heavenly Father. God bless you. I hope something I said may encourage your heart today. And let us keep on trusting God. Learn to trust in God in all circumstances and scenarios. No matter how ugly or bad it may look like, know that God is working behind the scenes. Even though we don't see it, he is working and will continue to work out all things good for in our lives for his glory. See you next week. Goodbye.